Welcome back to Design Bundles YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal, and today we are going to create a stencil with our Cricut. Now, I have already cut mine out, and I just use removable vinyl. What's really cool is I use the new Cricut Explorer 3. You could definitely do this with the new maker as well. And I use that roll holder so that way I can make this as big as I could, because this is now 13 inches, which I still did, I think, 11.5 wide, but it gave me that length and I didn't have to, stick with that 12 by 24 mat. So I've already cut this out, like I said, removable vinyl. So you can definitely use stencil vinyl and all of those things. I got my rug from Target. This is just a room essentials. These are around $10. But you can definitely pick these up at most craft stores. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and remove this little guy right off of here. So let's go ahead and get rid of this. And then let's go ahead and start weeding this out. I'm not gonna lay this out completely flat just yet because my camera wants to kind of do this. But what we're gonna do first is we're gonna weed everything out. So basically you're doing like an opposite weed. So we're gonna remove the letters. So whenever you're trying to create a stencil, you're gonna weed everything backwards. I know it's gonna be really hard to tell what I'm doing since I chose white. I don't know what I was thinking for the weeding part. So let me go ahead and zoom through here. Now, a few other things that you're going to need is I like to use stencil brushes for this, which I'll show you what they look like right here. So they look like this, and they actually have a hard bristle. These are perfect for your stenciling for this, so I highly recommend that you guys get some. I'll link some down below for y'all. These are from Plaid, and it comes with a couple in a pack, so you get different sizes. So I'm actually gonna show you guys how you can add this onto your mat without transfer tape, because you know, when you add in another thing on top of something that doesn't have good, something to adhere to, you're just adding another element to mess with and fiddle with. So you really wanna try to avoid having to use transfer tape. So I'm gonna show you guys that today. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna very gently flip this over and I'm gonna start to peel this off, because I don't wanna use transfer tape, because if I do, it's just adding another element. All right, so we're gonna very gently, I'm gonna speed this up for y'all. This is gonna be a very slow, kind of tedious process. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna very carefully, I'll take my weeding tool as I need to pop these off. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna remove this from the backing. I know you guys are watching this and you're thinking, what are you doing? Yes, it's gonna be a little bit scary. Try not to let your pieces of vinyl touch like this. So you definitely wanna be very careful. And what we can do to get this to help us along is I'm actually gonna take two push pins here. I'm gonna take one here, one on this end, and I may even actually take one in the middle here. And I can actually even temporary get one right in here and here. And that way, those are gonna kind of hold still for me so they won't keep wanting to come up and attach this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and quickly peel this off. So as I'm going along, you guys are noticing I'm adding more push pins. We'll pull all these out here in a minute. It'll be a lot easier when we go to flip it. But we're just nearing the end here, so I'm trying to be careful to get the rest of this off. Now it looks like a hot mess, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to carefully pull all these push pins back out. I'll kind of hold one of my corners here. So the reason why I say to use removable is because if this sticks on itself, it's a lot easier to separate. If you use permanent vinyl, there's really no separating it. Once it starts to stick together, there's no undoing it. So highly recommend either use the stencil material, and you can definitely pull this off, or you can definitely do this with the removable vinyl. So what I'm gonna do, and I know this probably scares some of you guys, so you definitely don't have to try this method. I have more methods coming, plus we've done others on the channel here. But I wanted to show you guys this way. I know it sounds crazy, but this is the way I do it quite often. So I'm gonna go ahead now and I'm gonna grab this. So we're gonna go ahead and grab it like this, but I'm gonna be careful because, you know, I'm on camera, so I'm trying to very carefully flip this. So you just wanna kind of grab it like this quickly and we're gonna flip it around. Now, like I said, you see how it's starting to kind of stick, but because it's removable, it's easy to kind of move. I don't have a bunch of intricate pieces, so I don't have to worry about it. See how easy that was? It seemed really scary, but it's not. It's removable vinyl, so it's super easy to maneuver. I'm gonna go ahead and kind of get it somewhat stretched out here, and then I'm gonna adjust exactly where I want it to sit on the mat. So I'm just gonna go ahead, I'm just smoothing everything out at this point, just so I can kind of figure out about where I want it to lay. Now, like I said, this method may not be for everybody, but once you guys see that I start to smooth it all out, it's okay. Removable vinyl is very forgiving. I know some of you guys, when it started to do that, you guys would have panicked and wadded this thing up and been done. Sister, trust me, sometimes I do that too with things. But I promise you, don't get too scared. As long as you just have basics like this, it's not bad. We don't have real intricate pieces. Now I'm just making sure. We don't want it distorted, obviously. So I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure I smooth everything out. Once I smooth everything out, I can then kind of eyeball it too and see if we need to make any adjustments. Like I said, I'm just smoothing everything out. And if I feel like I need to kind of tug some pieces down or over or whatever, that's kind of what I'm doing at this point. So as you guys can see, it laid down. I know it seems super scary, and some of you guys are probably like, what the heck, girl? No way. Or some of you guys have already ran. You guys have already shut this video off and ran. But I promise you guys, it's really not bad. Because whenever you go to use that transfer tape, sometimes that is a lot harder because you're going to get it down. It's really hard to struggle to then get this to stick and pull that all the way off. So really, I mean, it's just transfer tape versus no transfer tape whenever it comes to using this, you know, adhesive vinyl. So I think everything looks okay. I may need to adjust right in here. I can kind of see a little bit of distortion, maybe a little bit there. I'm just smoothing everything out. Now, once I think I have everybody where I want it to be, any areas that may need a needle at that point, I may need to kind of hold these down to kind of help me as we go in here and add our, you know, our paints. We can definitely do that. So I can go ahead and go in here and add a couple needles in here. This is just gonna help hold this material seal. Really, it's holding quite well, but just to be safe. So we're just gonna go ahead and put a few push pins in here and there just to kind of help hold this still as we're adding the paint. So maybe we wanna add one on each of these pieces here, so on and so forth. Sometimes even like these little points, I like to do this so that way I know that these ones aren't gonna move. These ones are the ones you really want to worry about. I've got a little piece of lint there. So these are the ones you really want to worry about. So I'll come in with those, maybe even on this one here, as well as this one. Very careful, just trying to get it on there, because when I go to get my brush, it'll be okay. And then I think I'm going to do the same with this little guy right here. I think everything else is looking good. Maybe one here. Double checking all my pieces here. I may do those. Oh, we got two more little pieces here, I think, that I would like one on. So there we go. All right, so all we have left now is going back and finding our pieces that go in here. These pieces I just added in, I definitely want to add a needle on each of these. And we are going to be ready to paint. All right, so we've got our acrylic paint. I've just got something to put it on. We're just gonna go ahead and get some of that going here. And then I've got my stencil brushes. I've got two different sizes, a smaller one and a big one. Like I said, this is more of a stiff brush. So you wanna do a pouncing motion, right? So we're gonna go ahead and start out with that small one here. And I just wanna kinda dab some of that off. And we're just gonna go ahead and go in. And I realized I forgot a pin. After all my million pins, I forgot one. So we're gonna go ahead and just kind of pounce all the way around until all of the paint is in here. So this is just really helping kind of push it in, and it's gonna stay right inside of that stencil. So I'm just gonna go ahead and continue to do this entire thing until all of it is covered. So you can always go backwards and see if there's anything you missed at the very end. So as scary as this seemed by doing this by hand with that removable, it seemed like it was literally going to stick with each other. It was going to be a mess. It's truly not that bad. You know, it's a little scary, a little bit intimidating. And, you know, and I said beginner friendly, but maybe more intermediate. Definitely give it a shot. These sheets like this, say you've got $2 invested. If it messes up, then definitely just try out your stencil vinyl. But I'm not a fan of using the transfer tape because it's just pretty tedious. I also see that as a little bit harder to remove because I don't have anything helping me hold it down. But you may see that easier than my method here. But we have lots of different methods here on the channel as well as on YouTube, which is amazing about YouTube. So we have lots of different ways that we can do these. And I just thought, you know, this is another way to show y'all that there's other ways to do it besides, you know, wasting a huge piece of transfer tape along with, you know, the tediousness of trying to get it to let go of that vinyl. All right, so at this point, I'm just kind of going back and darkening up any areas that seem a little lighter. So I think I'm happy with this. I can always come back later and adjust anything after the fact as well with a smaller brush. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna go ahead and now remove all of these needles and then peel all of this. I don't let it dry. I just go ahead and do it while it's wet. So we're just gonna go ahead and pop all of these needles out really quick. We're just gonna pull this vinyl. We can stick it on top of the other one. So don't worry that it's wet. I love making stencils. They're perfect for Christmas gifts, you know, wedding gifts, housewarming gifts. They're a perfect item to sell, as well as making something for yourself. So I love to make them every season. I make me new ones, you know, for Christmas, Halloween, fall, all of those things, as well as football season and stuff like that. So we're just gonna go ahead and continue to pull all of these off until we get everything. And so I've got a few more right over here. Now we're ready for the big reveal. We're just gonna go ahead and peel off our vinyl here. Put that straight into the trash, and then we're gonna go ahead and pull off our remaining pieces. And just like that, look at how amazing this looks. So I can definitely come back in with a smaller paintbrush and I can come back in and fill in any more spots that I need to. So always feel free to come back and adjust those as needed. I really love the way that this came out. Like I said, definitely make sure you guys are using a paint that is made for outdoors so that way it can withstand the weather. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.